Plastic has become an integral part of our daily lives, and it carries a substantial environmental toll. Water bottles, grocery bags, medical supplies all contribute to more than 400 million tons of plastic produced every year, with one-third only used once and just 9% recycled. Beyond the substantial damage plastics cause to marine ecosystems, plastics also negatively impact human health and exacerbate climate change. As a global issue requiring a global response, the legal and policy framework provided by Multilateral Environmental Agreements, or MEAs, international goals and policies, and national legislation is essential to meet the challenges posed by plastic. InforMEA is the United Nations database on MEAs, where you can search and retrieve this diverse and scattered information. Marine plastic litter is a major issue, with 8 million tons ending up in the ocean every year. This is the result of many factors, including changing production and consumption patterns and inadequate waste management. Marine litter is particularly difficult to regulate, as it can originate from diverse land and sea-based sources, both within and outside of a state, and the seas and oceans polluted are not governed unilaterally. Global and regional MEAs play an important role in addressing this issue. The United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea places a broad obligation on states to prevent, reduce, and control pollution from land entering marine environments. Many regional MEAs, known as Regional Seas Agreements, such as the Barcelona Convention in the Mediterranean, have developed legally binding protocols and action plans to address the complex challenges posed by marine litter. MEAs on chemicals and waste are also useful for regulating plastics. In 2019, the Basel Convention was amended to include some plastics as hazardous waste, promoting better control over their movement across borders. Meanwhile, the Stockholm Convention works to regulate persistent organic pollutants, or POPs, which can leak from plastics left in water, accumulating in the tissues of marine species. Not only are POPs harmful to biodiversity, but they can impact the health of people who ingest these toxins as they work their way up the food chain, damaging the nervous system, lungs, and reproductive organs. Biodiversity MEAs have been studying the extent of these impacts. Beyond the adverse effects plastic can have once disposed of, the production of plastic itself contributes to climate change. With growing production demands, by 2050, the annual CO2 emissions from the production and incineration of plastic are predicted to be 2.75 billion tons. That's the equivalent of running 615 coal power plants for a year. Meeting the reduction targets set out in the Paris Agreement will therefore require action to limit plastic production. While MEAs play a significant role in dealing with plastics, they cannot be successful without countries adopting plastics legislation. 127 countries now regulate plastic bags. For example, in Rwanda, they have been completely banned since 2008. International goals and policies also play an important role. For example, SDG 12 emphasizes that responsibility also lies with us, the consumers, to make good choices regarding our plastic use. InforMEA contains a detailed database of relevant national legislation and international goals and policies. However, voluntary action and national legislation are most effective when undertaken within a broader framework of international obligations and concerted action through MEAs and associated instruments. Governments, activists, and researchers can use InforMEA's comprehensive database to explore this complex web of law and policy and craft effective solutions.